प्रपन्न पारिजाताय तोत्र वेत्रैक पाणये ज्ञान मुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृत दुहे नमः। ओम नमो वेंकटेशाय। My best wishes and paripurna ashirvadams to all the viewers of Shri Venkateshwara Bhakti Channel. May the Almighty Shri Lord Venkateshwara bestow all kinds of prosperity, health, wealth and eternal happiness with paripurna lakshmi kataksams to you and the entire your family members and friends. Let us begin Bhagavad Gita, verse number 10 of 9th chapter. Shri Bhagavan Vacha Maya Dhyakshena Prakritihi सूयते सचराचरम् हेतु नानेन कौन्तेय जगद्विपरिवर्तते। नाउ फ्रॉम वर्स नंबर 7 भगवान कृष्ण इज एक्सप्लेनिंग अबाउट हिज कार्य बिकॉज दिस वर्ल्ड इज कार्य। इन अदर वर्ड्स वी कैन से इट्स एन इफेक्ट। द कारणत्वम इज अननोन। So now, if I ask, you know, the tree is caused by what? You will say seed. But if you cut the seed, you cannot see the tree over there. Though Bhagavad Gita already has explained that sthiti, the condition, the tree exists in subtle form called avyakta rupena. There are two kinds of avyaktas. So one is known as karana avyakta, another is known as Karya Avyakta. Also in the previous verses we learnt it. So Avyakta number 1, Avyakta number 2. Avyakta means that which is formless. Formless cause. Now God is formless cause. That cause is Avyakta number 1. Prakriti is formless cause. It becomes Avyakta number 2. That's what we call it Maya. So Maya is the matter, a material force. Therefore, every material has got the source in it. Water is containing with a current. When you go to the river, so river has its own current. And air, it has got its own flow. Do you know how the air travels? The nature of the air to travel. So nothing is pushing from behind because the space remains everywhere. Equally it is available. It doesn't have the force to push the air. The swabhava, the nature of air itself to travel. But air can push anything. In the same way, the water has got its own tendency. So it can drench everything. So anything, it takes time. So every object in this world, it has got three kinds of energy. What is that? That to create, to sustain, and to destroy something. Any object. So any object, sometimes you know you are hit by a stone. The stone might be kept somewhere else. You go and you hit with the stone. Or some other force. So sometimes something falls from the tree, the dry stick, because that doesn't have any intention to fall on your head. Dry stick, it is disconnected from the tree because dry stick doesn't have any force, but it comes through or because of gravitational force. So you go in between, you are hit. So every object has got its own force. What I mean to say, every object is connected with or through a particular force. That force is known as Maya. So Maya is also in the form of energy and in the form of matter. Now matter and energy itself is known as a force. That force, it has got its own programming. Now you cut this place, there the program will go automatically. It will heal itself, but it will take time. You need not to apply the medicine. Okay, as Sushruta, who invented operation in the first time in the universe. So he is the father of operation. And Sushruta Samhita, it gives a complete detail about so many medicinal plants and the nature of the body and how can one heal oneself. He gives in detailed way, but the thing is we are not having that much that medicinal plants nowadays. So this body has got its own program. So God is not coming and operating like a flight or JCB. JCB operated like this. So God is not sitting and physically operating and He is giving daily wages or the weekly wages. No, never. So God is there. So His presence itself, it makes everything get function. That concept alone, so we are understanding from the standpoint of a layman, a normal person. When you deal with the people, you are conscious enough, because when you speak and they will also speak. So when you speak something, when you share them something, they will become conscious enough and they will also react to you. But you are not that much consciousness enough to deal with the dead material. And there are people, they out of curiosity, out of madness, they become possessed with the object. Okay, that is also is kind of distracting the force, which is known as Maya. That's not dealing with the world. So now, if you want to deal with your body, you are dealing with Maya. And if you want to deal with any material in this world, whether it is movable or not, live or jada, now dead material, everything is nothing but Maya. You should learn how to, I think we should learn how to interact with Maya, because every object exists program in it. Okay, so what I mean to say, every object has gone its own program in it and its own cause in it. That programming nature, it has got with Prakriti itself. God has the programmer, He does nothing. Oh, there is an incident in my own life. So when I was young, I think I was studying the beginning stage. So I was sent to where Pathashala and school too. Daytime is to the school and night time means evening time I have to go to Pathashala. There are so many people around us. So one of our neighbor was an old man. So that person, suddenly he started digging the land in front of our door, means a little bit away. So he wanted to place a mango sapling. And I asked, so why are you, putting the sapling here? It would be disturbed for the road, because now though we don't have doors and walls, so in future we will be constructing. So I was young, at that time I asked. Then he said, no beta, so it will be very useful. Then what happened? That after a year passed and that old man, he passed away. After 15 years, yes. So what happened? So in our family, so that one of our Purvashrama relatives, so she was doing Rangoli in the morning. Maybe 6:30. At that time, the lorry which was going on the road, so due to some brake failure or what, we don't know, suddenly it took off from the road. It came towards our home and it got hit with that mango tree. That mango tree saved one of our aunt. So this is what, the mango tree, when he placed, the reason was unknown. So he had some other intention. The mango tree will give mango, but mango tree can also protect life. That's what Mayaji's program. She has a pakka program. Even she plans for thousands of years, billion, trillions of years. Therefore, Mayaji, which is in the form of material itself, which is in the form of energy in the material itself. Therefore, what is visible is Mayaji. And you don't know what is the program. Therefore, when a person comes in front of you, his mouth can talk something and mind can think something else. And he can talk and think similarly now. So, but after few months, he may change. Therefore, this marriage and all. So nowadays, there is a new system of marriage. You know, before marriage, we have to know each other. So then alone, we will be confident enough, even in the arranged marriage. So they want to, you know, become acquaintance with each other, familiar with each other. They want to talk, they want to share the feelings. Then they will confirm, okay, this banda, this person will be okay for you. This girl is okay for me. Now, so nature changes, your mind changes, and your ambitions changes. Your the way of presentation, it also changes. Everything changes. The man, he completely can change within 6 months, completely, entirely. Our physical system, it has got its own way of changing, but I'm talking about psychology, means a psychological system. So man grows and he changes fast. Mayaji. Therefore, you have to be very careful. Avyakta namni paramesha shakti. That's a paramesha shakti. And finally, so I explained it lot in the last few chapters. So when we were looking in the fourth chapter, I explained. Anirvachaniya rupa adbhuta. I said, sannapya sannapya bhayatmika no. Bhinnapya bhinnapya ubhayatmika no sangapya nangapya ubhayatmika no mahadbhuta nirvachaniya rupa. So Maya is anirvachaniya rupa. You cannot explain how she is. So how she works, no, nothing. Karyanu meya sudhiyaiva maya. Sudhiya eva karyanu meya. So if you are a scholar enough, and that scholar means you should have got some information, means knowledge from Vedas. Then alone you will be able to judge the karya of Maya, the actions of Maya. So it's very suspense. Therefore you are kept in the suspense, thrilling position. We don't know what is going to happen in the next minute. And you don't know, so you buy a mobile, you buy a car, and you buy a car, that car can give life, and that car can do something wrong. So anything happened, so everything kept suspense. That's what Mayaji. So when you deal with Mayaji, so you have to be very careful. I mean, when you deal with the world, even dead material, you should be very careful with your clothes, your material, and having possession on the object. Again, you commit mistake. There you commit mistake. Therefore, what? In order to get victory over Maya, you should surrender the Mayavi. That's what he said. Surrender means what? You should come to know, you should understand, you should realize what exactly the nature of Mayavi. That's what we are trying to understand. Ishvara, who is endowed with asangatvam, detached with the world, but the world is functioned by him. His presence itself, it functions. Therefore, I made it in different way. The world is created by Ishvara and through Maya, not with the help of Maya, because he is the owner. So this Maya becomes worker. And the relationship between Jiva and Maya, Maya becomes owner, then Jiva becomes slave. But relationship between Maya and Ishvara, so only it is known as Mithya Sambandham. Mithya Sambandham means as if relationship. The relationship how? So in a hall, so a party is going on, or meeting is going on, some function is going on, or some play is going on. So many activities. When you talk about sports, so it has got too much activity. But the light of that hall, particular hall, it is there. So light illumines that hall. It becomes what? A source to get brightness. It will help for the sports. but the light is unaffected by the actions of the hall. In the same way, Ishvara, who is endowed with Sakshitva, Sakshi Bhava, therefore what? He is not endowed with Karmapala. The Karmapala cannot give bondage to him. That's what, you know. So when here, look at my hand. So hand is visible because of what? The light. But if I do like this, if I do or fold and unfold, so whatever I do, so light helps us to see. It means life illumines that, but light is not endowed with activity and it is not affected by the activities of the hand. The same way, Ishvara, whose presence becomes the source of creation, sustenance and dissolution. That's what we have to understand. So when you understand God like this, you may not get so many idiotic questions. So usually, you know, people ask, you know, so when God comes and he does anything, so he will also have the headache. So in the beginning upasana, so once what happened in the Ramakrishna mission, so it's a beautiful mission, you know. So Swami Vivekananda, who was the founder of it, and it has created lots of sevakas, and still and this missions, like so many other missions also there. Okay, don't think of only these missions, but every mission they are doing well. In the Ramakrishna missions, so I was there in the Ramakrishna mission for 8 years as a brahmachari. So once what happened, they do Navaratri puja and they establish Kali. Now during that time there was an incident. So one senior pujari was there, and I was also fixed as a assistant for puja. Once what happened, after cleaning, you know, nirmalyam, everything done during night, then I switched off the fan of that prayer hall. And he said, no, no, keep it on because it's a humidity. The Kali may set sweating. Therefore, you know, in the morning we will switch off. Then I become shocked. The Kali, how can she sweat? Because she is a Srishti Sthiti Laya Karanam. And they just said that Kali is in Smasana always. So how can she sweat? I didn't ask because he was a senior pujari. Then I kept myself, you know, as an observer of him. Then I started observing, my God, he used to speak with Kali, like Ramakrishna, and he used to speak with the doors of the prayer hall and floor of the prayer hall, and he used to talk to all the objects. Then I thought, okay, is it the spiritual things to be done? Then later on I learned, that's what bhavana. You give life to the deity when you are able to communicate with that. That is the bhavana when you do saguna brahma upasana. So that bhavana dealing with the prakriti, you know. So how nicely they have set. So that bhavana, so here, so we should understand in different way. Because light exists unaffected, but all the actions which is maya karyam. Therefore, we need not to get confused. So this, how can God will get sweating? Now we have got the answer. That's an attitude which was fixed by that sadhaka. So he uses the bhakti in different way. Therefore, here every question is answered. Okay, how can God will appear in the form as the Kali? Now we got the answer. Because the prakriti is the owner. The maya can do anything because every material has got life, Brahman in it. Why can't it will appear as the Kali? Definitely it is possible. The next words, avajananti mam mudhaha manushintanum ashritam param bhavam ajanantaha mama bhuta maheshwaram. Now, mudhaha mam manushim tanum ashritam iti avajananti. But these people who are not having shraddha, who doesn't have the knowledge of shastra, who doesn't know the reality of maya and prakriti tattva, they think, though I have taken human body. So again, this is the similar words which we saw in the fourth chapter. So God can appear as a human being. It doesn't mean that he has undergone the karma and the influence of karma, the result of karma, and he is bound or bind by karma. It's not like that. That's what I said. Divyam karma janma, divyam janma cha karma cha. That's what he said. Mama param bhavam ajanantaha. They are not aware about my para prakriti. Para prakriti means what? Which is endowed with sakshitvam. Mere presence itself, it will work everything, because this apara prakriti is given the energy source from the Brahman. So Ishvara here, it is known as paraprakriti. Paraprakriti which gives potential capacity to this aparaprakriti. So this Brahman becomes source of that. So not knowing this reality, people think so that I am born, I have been locked with karma phala, but I am Bhutana Maheshwaraha. So I am the Lord, I am the Ishvara of entire creation. So this mistake is committed by maximum amount of people. Because when they, even now, they think Krishna is not the God. They don't think Rama is not the God. Even they don't respect the God, the incarnations of the God. So some people say that all of them are plop, plop, plop. No, they are not plop. They were real. They are not plop. Please don't commit that mistake. Once you enter into spiritual things, spiritual path, you please don't comment on any habit, any ritual or any belief. A person, you know, so one sadhu, he used to give a rock, only rock. Whoever comes, he gives whatever the near object is available, sometimes small stones, sometimes a small amount of sand. Sometimes he used to give water. But he says, you know, once I asked, why are you giving like this? People are criticizing you. No. Then he said, Baba, so what and all should be given, it is given. What and all should be received by those people. So only those people know what I am giving and I know what they gain. It's a kind of maya, it's a prakriti, because that material, I put sankalpa, just I take a few stones, small stones, and I put sankalpa, so Lakshmivan bhava, Lakshmivanto bhava, that's all, he will be, you know, multi-millionaire. That, how confident that sadhu, I was shocked. So it was a moment, you know, how can one have this much confidence? He said that this is not rock, this is my sankalpa. Why? Because every object is endowed with aparaprakriti, and in the aparaprakriti, the substratum is paraprakriti, only the sankalpa. Therefore, all our rishis, you could see the prayer, so you know, bhadram karne bhishrunayama devaha. What does it mean? Bhadram shrunayama, you know. So let us listen, or we may listen only auspicious. Then it comes bhadram pashyama. Bhadram karne bhishrunayama devaha. Bhadram pashyama akshabhir ejatraha. Sthirai rangai estushtavagum sastano bhihi. So it goes like this. Bhadram shrunayam. Because you should remember Abhimanyu, one who was listening from the stomach. So this is the organ first it works. So according to our Purana, this listening capacity, every stone has got the listening capacity, every material has got the listening capacity. So I have seen, you know, Certain people, they go and talking to deities, it's not a big deal. But they talk to even Nandiji, you know, Nandikeshwar. They go and they say, so it's like, you know, assistant, you know. So when Pujari gives bone, then alone we will get Devatas for the bone. It's said, it's like a proverb. Like, so Abhimanyu could hear. So hearing is the first source of knowledge. Bhadram Shrunuyama means we may listen only auspicious. Setting Sankalpa. So Sankalpa was made by whom? Rishis. Where they were, where they dwell, only in the caves in those days. Being in the cave, they were having lots of Sankalpa, 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 Sankalpa. Sankalpa means what? For the auspicious things to the universe. All the prayers only auspicious. Therefore, if you go now also in the caves, there are so many crowd goes. So, you know, it goes to sadhu's caves. Though the cave is empty, still people go because they know secret. Unknowingly, human beings are aware. So, if there is a rishi, if there is a yogi, if there was a yogi, then that place has got potential power. Because he knows how to deal with paraprakriti and aparaprakriti. That's what the secret. So once you understand the reality, means the truth, the real reality, you will become very careful. You don't comment on any habits. Any habits in the spiritual activities. Sometimes, you know, if they are not informed through a guru, okay, so then their method may be a little bit funny. Little bit of madness, endowed with madness, but we don't open our mouth, okay? But we have to become responsible people when we interact with the world, when we interact with our own sharira. So because somehow, because of the God's grace, we have got proper knowledge. We should know how to execute with the world and how to interact with all other beings. So not like him. So Krishna was denied by Duryodhana, etc., etc., Shishupala, etc., people. Now, even now there are lots of Duryodhanas. And we need not to say even that, so everybody is Duryodhana who is not accepting Krishna. No. But the Duryodhanatva should not be there within us. So we have to take from our system. That's what the understanding should come, because Moghashaha, in the next words, Bhagavan himself says, so those people who are not accepting me as the God, so what is the benefit, means what the life they would adapt, what kind of life, that would be definitely hell life, I tell you. But Bhagavan himself, he explains, let us read it. Moghasha Mogha Karmanaha Moghajnana vichetasaha rakshasimasurin chaiva prakritim mohinim shritaha. So their entire actions throughout the life becomes vain, useless. So Bhagavan Krishna himself, he says, moghashaha. There are lots of desires they want. All of them are useless, meaningless. So meaningless desire. So what kind of desire, that we will see in the next episode tomorrow. We'll continue with that. Harihi Om.